STP stands for Spanning Tree Protocol. Fine. Now guys, first thing, we have different flavors of STP. Fine. All of you know there are two things. One is, other one is Cisco key. It means Cisco Pro Priority. Fine. First of all guys, open standard people come up with a technology called CST. Fine. That is also called some of you call it fine. Cisco first of all come up with PVST. Fine. So first of all we will discuss about CST, then we will come to PVST. Clear? Clear?
Yes sir.
So what is CST? I am starting with it. CST. CST stands for Common Spanning Tree. Now guys, look here. What was the problem whenever we connect switches using redundant links, there can be a chance that loop can form. There can be a chance that loop can form. Now guys, first thing that all of you have to understand, what is a loop? So I think we have discussed about it while discussing Ether channel, but I am explaining it once again to make sure it is clear to everybody. Fine. So what is a loop? Let's say let's say we are connecting switches using redundant links. Which links? Fine. And let's say we have users. So whenever a user wants to communicate with another user, what he will do? He will generate a ARP. Clear? What switch will do with ARP packet? Switch will broadcast it, or switch will flood it out of all the ports except the receiving port. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now switch will send this particular ARP packet in which source MAC is A to all the ports. It means this source MAC will be learned on port number 1 also and port number 2 also of switch 2.
Yes, sir.
So this particular condition is called loop. This particular condition is called loop. Clear?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is loop? Whenever? Bolo ab.
Whenever source MAC address is learned from multiple ports on a switch.
Whenever same MAC is learned on multiple ports of same switch, this particular condition is called loop. Clear? And whenever loop will form, there will be a situation called broadcast strong. There will be a condition called
broadcast strong.
Broadcast strong. Clear? What is broadcast strong? Look here. Let's say this is switch 1. This is switch 2. Done. They are connected via redundant links. They are connected via?
Redundant links.
It is 10.1. It is 10.2. MAC address A, MAC address B. Let's say 10.1 want to communicate with 10.2. What 10.1 will do? It will generate a ARP. What switch will do? Switch will flood this ARP out of all the ports except receiving port. It means switch will flood this ARP packet out of port number 1 and 2. Switch 2 will be receiving same MAC on both the ports, yes or no?
Yes.
So switch 2 will be first of all giving you a notification that MAC is flapping between which interfaces? 1 and? It means on interface number 1 and 2 switch is learning same MAC. Now, the broadcast traffic which is received on port number 1 will be flooded to port number 2, and the broadcast traffic which is received on port number 2 will be flooded to port number 1. Clear? And this traffic will start revolving like this. Will start moving like this. This particular condition is called broadcast strong. Clear? Any issues to anyone? Anyone who is not clear with this thing? Anyone? Ah, bhai. Yes, you? Clear? Done.
Switch is receiving the same packet from two interfaces on its two interfaces. Again, why the same little forward to the same interface again? Switch should not forward the same packet.
What is the rule? Rule kya hai? Ek minute, main concern clear kar deta hun. Let me clear this question to all of you so you can also understand. What is saying switch 2 is receiving same traffic on both the interfaces. Why it is forwarding back that traffic back to switch 1? Now my concern is what is the rule by default? The port on which we are receiving the traffic, we will not forward same traffic out of that port. This is the rule. Switch is following that rule. Which is following that rule. The traffic it is receiving on port number 1, it is forwarding it to port number
2.
The traffic it is receiving on port number 2, it is forwarding it to port number 1. Now my question is, how switch will get to know that on both the ports it has received the same traffic?
Because inter-channel misconfiguration
learned on.
What the fuck you are talking, man? That's why I told you, please do your practicals first. There will be nothing like that, like he's speaking, fine. The thing is, what was the concept that we have studied? That whenever switch will receive broadcast on one port, it will forward it out of all the ports except
receiving port.
Clear? To all of you,
yes.
Let me show you this fucking condition. It's not literally fucking, please. Joke tha ye bhi, ab dekho ek. Please guys, please. You don't have to talk. Done? Deedar ko terse akhiyan.
यार बात बहुत करते हो एक तो. व्हाई यू आर टॉकिंग ब्रो? एनी डाउट? यू हैव अ डाउट? आस्क मी. टेल. What was the issue?
So you don't know the first rule? What was the problem? Can you tell?
You were not getting
that thing. The thing was switch 1 was forwarding broadcast to 2. Switch 2 will forward it back to 1. 1 will forward it back to 2. So like this way this packet will keep on moving. Because the rule is on the port on which broadcast is received, except that port we can flood it out of all the ports. So it will keep on moving.
Shut 1/0/19 to shut host 10:00 host. Ten zero zero. Look here. Look here, this is my diagram. Switch 1 connected to switch 2, port number host 2 10.1 10. done. Show CDP neighbor. Look here. On host A port will be. On host 2 port will be. Clear? Port number 1, port number 2. Done? All of you are clear with physical topology?
Yes, sir.
Check CDB table on switch 1. Switch 1 is connected to switch 2. And host. Switch 2 is connected to host 2 and switch 1. By default, look here. The other switch is root bridge. Sorry, this switch is root bridge. Show spanning tree, check. All the ports are designated on other switch. One port is root, another is block to prevent the loop. To prevent the loop. Clear? So what I will do? I've disabled spanning tree. I've disabled spanning tree. This time spanning tree is not working. Look here. Show interface FA0/0 section BW. Sorry, BIA. What is MAC address of this user? D98. Let's say I am sending traffic from this user. Ping 10002. You can see this error. D98 is flapping between interface 21 and 20. D98 is flapping. Okay, who is 6F E9? Let me show you. He is 6F E9. This MAC address is also flapping. You can see all of you. And this MAC address D98, it is also flapping. You can see this particular condition is called loop. This packet will keep on moving. This packet is never discarded. Why? Because in case of layer 2 header, in case of there is no TTL field. There is no TTL. See, if a packet is looped in a layer 3 environment, that packet will be dropped after 255 ops. But if a packet is looped in a layer 2 environment, it is never dropped. Clear? So this result will keep on. We will keep on getting this result. You can see here success rate is 1. Clear? Again, ping. Because packet is in loop. Now look here. Show check CPU utilization of switch. 70%. See, now no traffic is forwarded through switch. Yes, switch abhi koi traffic forward kar raha?
No.
This switch is forwarding any traffic?
No.
Still CPU utilization is 70%. This is because of the condition called loop. This is because of which condition? So loop will directly impact CPU utilization. Loop will directly impact
CPU utilization.
So if switch CPU utilization will be high, there can be a chance processor of switch will fail. Abhi to now this switch is not forwarding any type of traffic. If traffic is also there and CPU utilization is 70%, there can be a chance that switch processor will fail. हो सकता है स्विच का प्रोसेसर क्या हो जाए, फेल. क्लियर? ओके, लेट्स से स्पैनिंग ट्री VLAN 1. आई एम रनिंग स्पैनिंग ट्री फॉर विच VLAN? स्पैनिंग ट्री VLAN. We are running spanning tree. So spanning will tree will take around 30 seconds to converge. How much time? 30 seconds. Wait. Last 21 packets are successful. Now again, other 100 are also successful. Why? Because one port is blocked by spanning tree and loop is avoided. Loop is avoided. Clear? वही दिखा रहा हूँ. This is normal CPU utilization. Clear? So there is a difference between 5% and 70%. You can understand? Fine. Aur bhi kam hoga abhi to. कितना हो गया? क्लियर? लेट्स से स्विच इज फॉरवर्डिंग ट्रैफिक. स्विच ट्रैफिक फॉरवर्ड कर रहा है, स्टिल 4%. स्विच इज फॉरवर्डिंग ट्रैफिक, दिख रहा है मैंने ट्रैफिक फॉरवर्ड किया हुआ है, स्टिल सीपीयू यूटिलाइजेशन इज क्लियर. But in case of loop, utilization of switch will increase. Fine. So in interviews or in real time scenarios, if there is a loop on your switch, what thing you will check first of all? CPU utilization. If it is very high, just remove your switch from the topology. Just remove your switch from the topology. Clear? Find out a solution, then connect that switch again. Find out the solution, then connect that switch again. Clear? Or interviewer can ask this question like this. How in real time scenarios we will get to know that loop is formed? So you can tell him two things. Either you will be getting a log message of MAC flap. If logs are off, in that case you can check CPU utilization. You can check. This thing is fine, guys.
Yes, sir.
Now I have shown you that spanning tree is preventing the loop. Agree? Now my concern is how spanning tree is preventing the loop. How spanning tree is preventing the loop. Fine. Look here, how CST will work. CST stands for now guys, there are basically two use of spanning tree. Kitne use of spanning tree hai?
Do.
Now listen to me carefully. Let's say we are connecting two switches using redundant links. using redundant links. What STP is doing? Spanning tree is blocking one link. It means only one link is utilized between two switches. We can never utilize more than one link. We can never utilize more than one link. So I asked this guy, what's your name? I asked Abhinav. Abhinav, do we have any other solution to do the same thing? Abhinav is saying, sir, please remove the second link. Please remove the second link. See, try to understand. Let's say I have two switches. Fine. They are connected using redundant links. They are connected using
redundant links.
First thing, if STP is working there, what is working there?
STP.
Now, switches has to run STP. Fine. Switches will block one link. All of you are clear with this thing. Now, I ask the same thing from Abhinav. Abhinav is like, sir, remove the second link if it is not used. If I remove the second link, one thing will happen. What? That there is no need to run spanning tree. If we are not having redundant links, there is no need to run spanning tree. Clear? Because if we don't have redundant links, there will be no loop. If we don't have redundant links, there will be no loops. So what we can do? We can have a linear topology instead of having a loop topology. Instead of having a looped topology. Instead of having a looped topology. What is the difference between linear and loop? Linear means one is connected with 2, 2 is connected with 3. Looped means one is connected with 2, 2 is connected with 3, 3 is again connected with 1. So what is the best way to prevent the loop? Convert loop topology into linear topology and there is no need to run spanning tree. And loop is prevented. But what will be the problem? Redundancy. What will be the problem?
Redundancy.
Clear? So spanning trees helping us in achieving two things. One is it is preventing loop. And second thing, if any of the link goes down, it will also provide us backup path. It will also provide us backup path, or you can call it redundancy. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So there are two uses of using spanning tree. One is to provide a loop-free path, and second, to achieve redundancy. To achieve
redundancy.
Clear? Anyone is having any problem?
No.
Aage chale. Now again, my concern is how spanning tree will prevent the loop. Spanning tree loop prevent karega kaise? How spanning tree will prevent the loop? To prevent the loop, first of all, switches will form a loop-free topology. Fine? To prevent the, first of all, switches will form the loop-free topology. Switches will form the loop-free topology. Clear? How? Fine. So, what is loop topology? And what is loop-free topology? Let me give you an example. Switch 1, switch 2. They are connected by redundant links. All of you know STP will block one port. So this link is never used for forwarding data. This link is never used for forwarding data. Never used for forwarding. So loop-free topology will be this. Clear? So this is physical topology and this is logical, or you can call it as loop free topology. You can call it loop free topology. Samajh mein aayo bhaiyo? Bhaiyo aayo? Chale bhai aage. Let's say I can have one more example. Let's say you have topology like this. So loop free topology will look like this. Done? Because this link will be blocked. Clear? So this will be the loop free topology and this is looped topology. This difference is clear to all of you?
Yes.
Next thing. Look here. Now, to form this loop-free topology, first of all, switches will elect one switch as root bridge. Switches kya elect karte hain apne among? Root bridge. They will elect one switch as root bridge among them. Clear? Now the question is how? Clear? Now look here. Done. Let's say port number 1, port number 2. Fine. Whenever we start any switch, by default all ports were in this state. By default, all ports were in which state? Disabled is like what do you mean by disabled state? When no wire is connected. Or port is shut down. Clear? So by default all switch ports were in this state. Disabled state. Fine. Now whenever you connect, wire to a switch port, it will directly move to this state. In listening states, it cannot
कितनी सेकंड रहेगा इस लिसनिंग स्टेट में? ऑल ऑफ यू कैन सी दिस फॉर हाउ मच टाइम इट विल रिमेन इन लिसनिंग स्टेट? 15 सेकंड्स एंड द थिंग्स इट विल बी डूइंग इट कैन सेंड बीपीडीयू इट कैन इट कैन नॉट इट कैन नॉट फॉरवर्ड डेटा इट मीन्स स्विच वन विल बी फॉरवर्डिंग इट्स बीपीडीयू टू स्विच टू स्विच टू विल बी फॉरवर्डिंग इट्स बीपीडीयू टू स्विच वन स्विच वन विल बी फॉरवर्डिंग इट टू स्विच थ्री थ्री विल बी फॉरवर्डिंग इट टू वन टू विल बी फॉरवर्डिंग इट टू थ्री थ्री विल बी फॉरवर्डिंग इट टू टू क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू सो बाय डिफॉल्ट ऑल स्विच पोर्ट्स आर इन स्टेट डिसेबल्ड व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय डिसेबल्ड स्टेट When no wire is connected or the port is shut down, after disabled state, they will directly enter in which state? Yes. In listening state, what they will do? They will send BPDU. They will. Next. They. They cannot learn MAC address. They cannot forward data. Now, guys, the whole thing that we will be discussing today is related to listening state. आज हम जितनी भी बातें पढ़ेंगे सारी किससे related होंगी? We will be discussing all the things that switch will be doing in which state? Listening state. Which state? Listening state. Clear? Now, what is the information in BPDU? This is the information present in a BPDU. All of you can see? Visible? Visible? First field is? Second is? Third is? Fourth is? Fifth. Root ID consists of two things. Root priority and MAC address of root bridge. So the first thing that all of you have to keep in mind is root ID is root bridge ID. Root bridge ID is combination of root bridge priority plus base MAC address of root bridge. Agree? Yes. Next thing is root path cost. Root path cost means cost to reach root bridge. Next field is the switch which is forwarding the BPD. Next thing, the port which is after the, we have got some timer values like hello, forward delay, max age, message age. Check here. So after root ID, what we have? After that? After that? After that, we have some timers. Message, age, max, age, hello, forward delay. About these timers, we will discuss later on. First of all, let's discuss these three things. Root ID, root path cost, bridge ID and port ID. Sorry, four things. Root ID, root path cost, bridge ID and port ID. Clear? ये चार चीजें हमेशा याद रखना. क्या क्या चार चीजें? Root bridge ID, root path cost, sender bridge ID, sender port ID. Repeat with me. Root bridge ID, root path cost, sender bridge ID, sender port ID. Clear? चले आगे. Now guys, switch 1 will forward its BPD to switch 2. Switch 2 will forward its BPD to switch 1. Now my concern is what will be the information in the BPD that is forwarded by switch 1 and what will be the information in the BPD that is forwarded by switch 2. Concern samajh mein aaya? The BPD which is forwarded by switch 1, what will be the information? The BPD which is forwarded by switch 2, what will be the information? Now look here. Whenever a switch comes up or whenever you turn on a switch, ye wo wala turn on nahi hai. नहीं आता लो जो भी समझ ले क्या. Whenever you turn on a switch, switch will assume itself as, switch will assume itself as root bridge. Switch will assume itself as
root bridge.
Done guys. Switch apne aap ko kya samjhega?
Root.
Let's talk from perspective of switch 1. Switch 1 is forwarding the BPD. Fine. First field is root ID. What is priority of switch 1 by default? What is MAC address of switch 1? A. So again I have to tell it is 0000A. Next thing is RPC. Cost to reach root bridge. As this switch is assuming itself as root, cost will be 0. Cost will be
0.
Why 0? RPC stands for root path cost. Cost to reach
root.
But this time switch is assuming itself as
root.
So RPC will be
0.
Next thing is sender bridge ID. Which switch is forwarding this BPDU? Priority. The same switch A is forwarding this BPDU, yes or no? Yes. Sender port ID. By default port priority is 128. By default port number is 1. Done. So this will be the information in the BPDU that will be forwarded by switch 1. Clear? Switch 1 jo BPDU forward karega usme ye information hogi. Fine. The BPDU which is forwarded by switch 2, what will be the information? Root bridge ID. Root path cost. Sender bridge ID. Sender port ID. Done. Switch 1 will forward BPDU to switch 2, switch 2 will forward it to 1. Now the question is, who is sending better BPDU? Yaar ruk to jao yaar, phir bhaag rahe ho. Nahi pata to hai hi hai. Itni tez mat karo. How better BPDU is selected. Better BPDU is selected on the basis of better root bridge ID. Switch 1 is also forwarding the BPDU, switch 2 is also forwarding the BPDU. Which switch contains better root bridge ID? 1 or 2?
1.
How we will get to know which one is better? क्या लिखा मैंने? Lowest bridge ID is preferred. By default, what is the priority present in the both the BPDUs? One switch is having MAC, the other switch is having MAC. Who is having better root bridge ID?
A.
So A will be elected as root. Now guys, it will work like this. Let's say we all are switches. We are connected together. But first of all, root bridge election will be happening on the directly connected segments. On the? Okay. Out of all of us switches, one switch be elected as root bridge, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agar hum sare kya hai? Switches. To hum sab mein se root bridge kitne banenge?
Ek.
But my concern is, first of all, the switches which are directly connected to me will get to know that I am the root. Clear? So what will happen? Listen to me carefully. Fine. All of you will start exchanging BPDUs. So let's say I am connected with him, and him. Clear? And I am having MAC address A. All of you are having worst MAC address as compared to me. Clear?
आपके सबके पास मैक एड्रेस है बट मेरे से क्या है खराब. फाइन, ऑल ऑफ यू हैव वर्स मैक एड्रेस देन मी. आई विल बी फॉरवर्डिंग अ बीपीडी 1 2 3 4. फोर गाइस विल बी रिसीविंग. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दे विल थिंक दैट हु इज द रूट. मी. हु इज द रूट? मी. सो वेन एवर अ स्विच विल रिसीव अ सुपीरियर बीपीडी. Whenever switch will receive
superior.
So what is superior BPDU? The BPDU with lowest bridge ID. Sorry, the BPDU with lowest root bridge ID. The BPDU with lowest root bridge ID is called superior BPDU. It's called
superior BPDU.
Fine. The switch which will receive superior BPDU will not transmit its BPDU again. Will wait for BPDU from
switch.
Will wait for BPDU from
root.
Let's say I have forwarded my BPDU to you. Whenever you will receive my first BPDU and you will get to know my root bridge ID is better, you will not forward your own BPDU. You will not forward your own BPD, you will wait for my BPD. You will wait for my BPD. Let's say between him and you, he's better. Let's say he's better. He will forward BPD to him. He will forward BPD to him. As soon as he will get to know he's better, he will stop forwarding BPD. Are you eating your khate ho?
Pani do usko pani. गोता मरवाओ गोता, जाओ जाओ मुंह धो के आओ. वो आपको पता चल रहा होगा, यहाँ तक नहीं आया. क्या हुआ? Now guys, first rule. Write it down. Whenever a switch will receive a superior BPDU, it will not generate its own BPDU again. Should I have to repeat it?
Yes.
Whenever a switch will receive a superior BPDU, it will not receive, sorry, it will not forward its own BPDU again. It will wait for BPDU from root bridge. It will wait for BPDU from root bridge. Clear? Fine? Done. So, switch 1 will forward BPDU to 2, switch 1 will forward BPDU to 3. Clear? So, 2 and 3 will stop sending their own BPDUs. They will start waiting for BPDU from the
switch 1.
Because switch 1 is elected as root bridge. Clear? Now, switch 1 will forward BPDU to 2 also, switch 1 will forward BPDU to 3 also. Now, my concern is, out of switch 2 and 3, who will forward BPDU? Switch 2 will forward to 2, or switch 2 will forward it to 3, or 3 will forward it to 2? Why switch 2?
Both will forward to each other.
Again, BPDU takes place between switch 2 and 3.
Before forwarding the BPDU, switches will first of all elect a root port. Which switches? Non-root bridge switches. Which switches? Non-root bridge switches. Will first of all elect which port? Root port. Clear? Now, try to understand my concern, guys. Try to understand my concern. Topology can be like this also. Done. In the beginning, one will forward BPDU to 2. 2 will forward it to 1 will forward it to 3 will forward it to 3 will forward to 4 will forward to 2 will forward to 4 will forward to 2. So switch 1 will be elected as root bridge for 2 and 3, because till now 4 does not know about 1. Clear? So now 1 will be forwarding BPDU to 2. Now what 2 will do? 2 will receive it and 2 will forward it. Switch 1 is forwarding BPDU to 3. 3 will receive and 3 will forward it. 3 will receive it and 3 will forward it. Clear to all of you? Now, first of all, on non-root bridge switches, which port is elected as root port? Which port is elected as
root
port? Okay, let us write some points about root port. Done?
Yes.
Now, look here. What will happen? Switch 1 will forward BPDU to switch 3. When 1 will forward the BPDU, root bridge ID will be of 32768 plus. Let's say these are MAC addresses of switches. A. Root path cost will be 0. Next. Sender bridge ID. 32768 plus A. Sender port ID 128 plus this port number. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Switch 3 will receive it on this port. What switch 3 will do? Ab dekh lo, ye process hota hai. I'm just showing you a process. Whenever A will forward BPDU, root bridge ID will be of switch A. Root path cost. Sender bridge ID. Done. 1 will send it to 2. What 2 will do?
2 will receive it, root bridge ID will remain same. Root path cost. Cost of this interface will be added. 0 plus, let's say these are 100 MB links. For 100 MB links, cost is 19. 100 plus 19. So cost of which interface is added? On which BPDO is received. On which BPDO is? Clear? Now this time sender bridge ID will be off. Plus B, and it will forward it out of this port. Clear? So whenever a switch will receive a BPDO, it will change cost and it will change sender bridge ID and then forward it to the other switch. Clear? Whenever a switch will receive BPDO, it will change cost and it will change sender bridge ID before forwarding it to another switch. Before forwarding it to another switch. Clear? Any doubt to anyone? Tell now. Any doubt? No. Switch 1. Switch 1 will forward BPDO to 3. Now 3 will forward it to 4. Clear? 1 will forward it to 2, 2 will also forward it to 4. Clear? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Sabko samajh mein aaya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now 4 will be receiving BPDO on this port also and this port also. On this port also cost is 38. On this port also cost will be
38.
On port number 1 and port number 2 cost will be same. When cost is same, what switches will check? First of all, to elect root port, switches will check cost. Second, they will check what they will check? What they will check? Again, I am asking what they will check. So whenever 2 will forward the BPDO, who will be the sender? B. When C will forward the BPDO, who will be the sender?
C.
It means in case of switch 4, this port will be elected as root port. Why? Because we are receiving BPDO via sender B, which is better than sender C. Clear?
Yes,
to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Next thing. Till now, all of you know two things. How RB is elected? And next thing. How RP is elected? How RP is elected? So first thing, by default, whenever all switches will come up, all of them will forward BPDO to each other. Now, whenever they will receive the superior BPDO, they will stop forwarding their own BPDO. They will start expecting BPDO from the upstream switch. From the
upstream
switch. Clear? Let's say we have this topology. Done. Let's say A will forward BPDO to B. B will forward to C2, D2, A2, D2, A. So D will get to know about A. So D will stop forwarding BPDO. B will get to know about A. B will stop forwarding BPDO. C will get to know about B. C will stop forwarding BPDO. Now A will forward BPDO. A will forward it to B. B will forward it to C. A will forward it to D. Now try to understand, in the same time D will be forwarding it to C. So C will be comparing BPDO on this port and on this port. On the port it is receiving superior BPDO, that port is elected as root port. That port is elected as?
Root port.
And which port it will be? Tell me.
B.
This port will be elected as? समझ में आई बात सबको सबको हरिशोर पक्का अब देखो Who will be root bridge? On D, which port will be root port? This port? On B? On E? Done on F? On C? Clear? So, these ports will be? Clear? Now, what will be the loop free topology? This will be the loop free topology. All other links which are shown in this topology are never used for forwarding traffic. All other links which are shown in this topology are never used for forwarding traffic. Clear? जितने भी और लिंक्स प्रेजेंट हैं इस टोपोलॉजी में वो कभी भी ट्रैफिक फॉरवर्ड करने के लिए यूज नहीं होंगे तो ये कैसी टोपोलॉजी है व्हाट इज इट लूप फ्री क्लियर एनी इश्यूज डन Now let's say case is this. MAC address is A, MAC address is B. Switch will forward BPDU. Out of both port, switch 2 will be receiving BPDU on this port also and this port also agree? Clear? Which port will become root port? Cost is same on both ports. Is also same. Now election will be done on sender port ID. Let's say port number 2, port number 1. So on switch 2, which port will become root port?
2.
Port number 2. Port number?
2.
Because we will always check sender port ID. We will always check
sender port
ID. Please keep this thing in mind. Please keep this thing in mind. In this case, this port will become And the above port will be clear?
Yes, sir.
And always keep this thing in mind. Smallest value is preferred. Smallest value is
preferred.
Done bhai. डन अब देखो इधर देखो लेट्स से दिस इज माय टोपोलॉजी फाइन ए विल फॉरवर्ड बीपीडी टू बी बी विल फॉरवर्ड टू बी विल फॉरवर्ड टू सी विल फॉरवर्ड टू ए विल फॉरवर्ड टू डी विल फॉरवर्ड टू इन द बिगिनिंग ऑल ऑफ देम विल रिसीव बीपीडीज हु विल रिसीव सुपीरियर बीपीडी डी And B, so these ports will be RP. Fine. Now C is expecting BPDU from B. C is expecting BPDU from B. Clear? Clear? Yes or no? So B will forward its BPDU to C. Clear? Now my question is, C will forward BPD to D or D will forward it to C? Try to understand my concern. On switch C, which port will be root port? Let the root port first of all. This port will be root port. So on this link, one port will be DP, other will be blocked. Yes or no?
Yes,
sir. So my concern is, which port will be DP, which port will be blocked? Clear? Now, my question is, C will forward BPD to D or D will forward it to C?
C will forward to D.
Why C will forward? So, what the fuck that meant? I don't think so.
On what basis designated port is elected?
Simple question. First of all, we will compare cost. Now try to understand. Ab meri baat samajh na. If C will forward BPDU to D, what will be the cost in that BPDU? 38. Clear?
Yes.
But if D will forward BPDU to C, what will be the cost?
19.
So who will forward? D. So first of all, we will compare cost. See, on a segment, whenever you have to think of a designated port, always think best port on the segment. Always think like best port on the segment is called designated port. Best port on the segment is called best port means the port which can send best BPDUs. The port which can send best BPDUs. So, this port can send which BPDU or this port?
D.
Which port can send?
D.
Because if D will send, cost will be 19. If C will send, cost will be. So, this will be DP and this port will be. Fine?
Yes, sir.
See, in front of root port, we always have designated port. So, this thing is clear to all of you. How designated port is elected? In front of root port, there is always designated port. I am talking about the links on which one port is designated port and another port is blocked. How you will elect designated port on those links? First of all, on the basis of cost. If cost is same, then you will check
sender bridge
ID. Then you will check sender bridge ID. Look here. A, B, done, 1, A to B, A to C, both ports are elected as root ports. Question is, on this link, which port will be DP and which port will be blocked? If this port will be forward the BPD, what will be the cost? If this port will forward, what will be the cost? So now we will compare. Sender bridge
ID.
So which sender is better, B or C?
B.
B is better, so this port will become designated port and this port will be
blocked.
Clear? So this link is never used for forwarding traffic. So what will be the loop free topology? A, B and C. Clear? So till now we have discussed three elections. First was? Second? Third? The ports which are elected as root port, designated ports will go in next state. That is? The ports which are not elected as designated or root will move to which state?
Blocking.
Will move to which state? Blocking. Bas 2 minute. Now look here. A, B, C. Elections are done. This port is elected as DP. RP. DP. DP. This port is block. The ports I am marking with red color, they will go in which state?
Learning.
This port will go in which state?
Blocking.
Done. In blocking state, port will just receive BP dues. Port will just receive BP dues. Second thing, port will never learn MAC address. Port will never learn MAC address. Clear? In DP or RP state, port can learn MAC address plus it can forward. It can forward data. It can forward data. This thing is clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Now, what will happen in learning state? Now, guys, try to understand. In the beginning, switches have started exchanging BP dues. With the help of BP dues, they have prevented the loop. Agree?
Yes,
by electing different port states. By electing some ports as DP, some ports as RP, and some ports as blocking ports. Now, in learning states, switch will start learning MAC addresses. Which will start learning? Just to verify, the loop it has prevented is actually prevented or
not.
So now what switches will do? Switches will send BP dues again. Ab root bridge BP dues send karega.
Yes.
And they will start learning MAC address and they will verify it that loop is prevented or
not.
Because how we were get to know that loop was formed? हमें पता कैसे चलता लूप फॉर्म हो गया?
He
got error like MAC flapping. Clear? So when, if there is still a loop, switches will again give us a error that MAC is flapping. So in learning state, switches are just testing this thing that loop is prevented or not. So in listening, oh sorry, in learning state, switches can learn MAC addresses. Switches can learn MAC addresses. This thing is clear?
Yes, yes.
So now for 15 seconds, this root bridge will keep on forwarding BP dues. These switch will keep on receiving BP dues. These switches will keep on receiving and they will verify that there is no loop. After 15 seconds of learning state, they will move to which state?
Forwarding.
And now users can forward data. Now port can forward data. Now port can forward
data.
This thing is clear?
Yes, sir.
So how much time HTTP is taking to converge? 30 seconds. See, first of all, ports were in disabled state. After that, they moved to listening state. In listening state, there will be three elections. First election. Second, root port. Third, designated ports. The ports which are elected as DP or RP will go in this state.
Learning.
Forwarding pe mat aao yaar. Kisme jayenge?
Learning.
The ports which are elected as nothing will go in this state. Blocking. In blocking state, port will keep on receiving BP dues. No MAC address will be learned. The ports which are in learning state, from those ports, BP due will be forwarded and switches will verify that loop is forming or not. After verification, port will go in forwarding state. Now those ports are ready to forward. Now those ports are ready to forward. Clear? So please revise the things that we have discussed today. Tomorrow I will be showing you practical of all of these things. Second thing, how to manipulate root bridge, how to manipulate root port, how to manipulate designated port. All of these things will be discussing. After that we will discuss how topology change will work. And after that, we will start with PVST. Yes.
Sir, you told that block port doesn't forward data. And the DP forwards data and BP due both. So from B2C, it will forward data also.
It will forward data also. If B is broadcasting anything, B will forward it to A also and
C
also. A also and
C. Yes.
But C will never learn the MAC address on this port. That's why loop is prevented.
Data will be dropped
there. Data will be dropped there. Yes. No data processing will be done on dropped ports. Sorry, blocked ports.